gone ahead to trace out the paper, and this is what it looks like. So the next thing we're going to do is to slash on the elbow line to point T, the middle line. So in order to create a dart, so I'm going to slash through this elbow line for point T. Okay. Then on T, we're going to crease line T so that we can get an opening here, a 5 cm opening. So we're going to crease and open till we have 5 cm. So I'll keep opening till I have 5 cm. You need to hold this down. Measure 5 cm. Measure till you get 5 cm. So this is a 5 cm here. Then you put paper underneath it. So you're creating this dart, bending it towards the side, the left side. Has exceeded the T line, so I need to close it. This is 0.5 cm here. Let me take it down. Tape this down also. see if we still have our 5 cm. Yes, we still do. So then you blend it in. You're gonna cut through it. The next thing you do, this 5 cm that hair crease is for the elbow, that's the function of the 5 cm, the elbow point. It gives it the bias effect when you cut it on the fabric. So that way it helps your elbow, allows free movements around the elbow. So the next thing you do is to rule out a new point T. And on this line, you're going to rule out your point T because it has been moved to this side. So you come to this side of the dart, this side, to rule your point T. Now the pattern is a fitted pattern, and we need to still tighten it, manipulate it further, and we're going to introduce our elbow measurement to the elbow length, the width of our elbow. We're going to introduce it around the elbow length, then the wrist measurement will also impute it there on the wrist. Now we will have a closely fitted sleeve. So the next thing we're going to do is to now get our elbow width measurement. We're going to draft exactly what we have there. For the record, this is the sleeve we're trying to achieve. This is Natalie Bray's tight fitting sleeve. This is the method she used. So this is what we're trying to draft here. So the next thing, like I said, is to get the elbow width. The elbow width for this pattern is elbow width is 31 cm. So we're going to divide 31 cm into 2, and that gives us 15.5. So we're going to come to this part and measure 15.5. No ease because it's fitted. So on the T line, we measure 15.5 here. Then we come to this line, we measure 15.5. Then we come to the wrist. We're going to measure 1/3 of the wrist measurement plus 1 cm to the left, and 2/3 of the wrist measurement to the right. So I have done the calculation. 1/3 of this wrist measurement is plus 1 is 6.8. All you have to do is calculate 1 divided by 3 times 17.5. You get the answer plus 1. Whatever you get, you add plus 1 to it. Then this one is 2 divided into 3 times 17.5. You get this answer. So the next thing you do is to mark that measurement. So to the left we have 1/3 of the wrist measurement, which is 1/3 of it plus 1 is 6.85, 6, 7, 8. So this is where it is. You're starting from this new T line. This is 0.8. 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is where our 8 starts from. Then you come to the right, you measure 2/3 of it. To the back is the B side, to the F side, the right side of the sleeve, you measure 2/3, which is 11.6 cm. So this is where my 11.6 cm is going to start from. So you're going to connect this from you. You're going to connect to the elbow line and connect to the wrist. That's the next thing to do. Then we need to figure out how to place our curve, because it's not a straight line. So we need to follow this line that is on this textbook. Follow the diagram. So we need to figure out how to place the curve to get that. So on this side, I'm going to place the curve like so, because this side is a bit, it's like this. I'm gonna place it like this. From my U, connect like this. See, then I'll come to my wrist, connect my wrist to my elbow point. The next one is to connect the one on this left side. So we have to really look at how it's been done, or how the shape that we have there. So I'm going to put my curve like this and connect. This place seems a bit straight. You to the balance mark, it's a bit this way, then this side to this side has this curvy effect. See, then this side to the balance mark also has a curvy effect. I'm going to take it this way. to take it to this point. That balance mat done looks a bit curvy to the opening, to the elbow length. So you just have to place your curve. So this is what we have. The next thing we're going to do is to blend this in. The next thing we're going to do is to cut out this part. Cut this part out. Then this part will also will be cut out, but because of the next step, we're going to leave it. Then by the time we're done, we'll now trim out the excess. The next thing we are to do is to get a measurement of 2.5 hair, 2 cm hair, 1 cm hair. Measurement of 2.5, which is in the textbook. Like I said, the next thing we need to do is to mark the measurement of 2.5, okay? 2 cm measurement at point E, level point, then 1 cm. Then we're going to cut it out and attach it to this side. So I'll go ahead and do that. Measure 2.5 at point U, measure 2 cm at point E. Now measure 1 cm at the wrist. Now we're going to connect them, then cut it out and attach it to this side. Cutting it out and putting that same measurement on this side. So like I said, we are not cutting this out yet. We're going to tip, put a fresh pattern paper underneath it and tape it down. That's this measurement that we just took of 2.5, 2 cm and 1 cm. We're going to come to point G and measure it, okay, from this line, new line that we just marked, okay. So 2.5 at point U, the elbow line, this elbow line, we measured 2 cm, then here we measure 1 cm. So we're gonna connect. So you extend this balance mark so as your guide to roll this. Balance mark for E. Just like we did to this part. Just have to get it right. Okay. Side is a bit curvy here. Take your curve and match again to your point E from the balance mark, 5 cm balance mark. So you cut this piece out. The remaining excess, you cut it out. is to throw out this place, the waste. So you place your paper underneath it. Tape it down. This form of sleeve, it's when you get to in the retro styles that we used to have back then, that we had back then, had dotted sleeve at the side. So it's more like an old school kind of sleeve, very fitted there with that. Come across a sleeve like that. This is how the sleeve is being cut. You throw this out. Now, if you need to, if you don't want to hold the dart, all you have to do, because with the darts, the back is now very long, way longer than the front arm. You don't want to hold this dart. Come down here, you measure the value of the dart at the wrist and you pick it up. So you measure 5 cm. Which is the amount of opening that we have. You connect. Cut it up. It doesn't affect the purpose of this dart. The opening, you still have that curve, that effect. That the opening is meant for. So this is what it's going to look like. So let's say you're cutting it up. So it's going to look like this. So that's what your dart sleeve is going to look like. Of course, when you're sewing this side, the way you have to push it in when sewing, push it in without any. I think it's called fabric manipulation. The way you sew that, it goes in. So that's that about the fitted or the fringe sleeve. The next sleeve we'll be doing is the semi-fitted sleeve. See you in the next class. What we'll be working on is the semi-shaped sleeve, and I have gone ahead to I traced the pattern for that using this particular pattern that we took 1 cm on both sides and closed it. Traced it out, and this is the pattern I'm using for it. And before we go into that, I need to explain this, how you can cut the sleeve pattern, the fabric, the things to consider when cutting the fitted sleeve pattern. For this, you might want to consider using a stretchy fabric for this. But if not, if you're using a fabric that is not stretchy, because of the fitted, because of the fitted wrist, because it's really fitted, you will need to put a zipper to be able to open it, so that you can put your hand, or you use a button. That is what I wanted us to know about this. So if you're considering using a fitted sleeve, consider the fabric you're using, and also consider what you're going to use to be able to fit in your sleeve into the sleeve or your hand into the sleeve. So the semi-shaped sleeve is similar to this. It's the first thing you're going to do after getting the tree start pattern, because this is called the preliminary stage of the sleeve. So this is the first thing you do in order to get this, in order to create the semi-shaped sleeve or the shaped sleeve. So like I said, I've done that, and we need to now draft the sleeve or manipulate it into a semi-fitted sleeve. So the first thing I'll do is to slash. I've already slashed from the elbow length to point T. Then I'm going to take a dart of 3. I'm going to open a dart of 3 to 3.5 cm. So this is it. I'm going to use 3 cm. I'm opening 3 cm dart. Then of course you have to crease here to be able to get that flat. Get this, make this place flat. Then we tip this down also. To make sure that this piece is laying flat properly. And you unpin them. Make sure it's properly laid. Check if we have 3 cm. Yeah, 3 cm. So the next thing we're going to do is to get our T, our new T line. Because of the dart, it has shifted. So we'll come. Before that, we need to blend this in. Slash out the SS. So we come to this one. Then we move to the, after slashing it open, we move to slashing out the SS, taking it off. We come to the T point. We draw our T on this line. We redraw our T to point E, to the E line. So this is now our new T. Then the next thing we do is to mark our elbow width. So for this, the elbow width for this is 31 divided by 2 is 16.5. Elbow width is 31 divided by 2 is 15.5, and you're going to add a 1 to 1.5 cm. So we come here, you add 15.5, and I'll add 1 cm. Then I'll come here, I'll measure 15.5 So depending on how loose you want it, I decided to use 1 cm. You can use 1.5. So 1 cm. Then on the wrist, I'm going to come get half of the wrist measurement and add the ease also. So here, half of the wrist measurement is 17.5 divided into 2 is 8.75. Then I'm going to add 3 cm, 8.75 plus 3 cm is 11.75. So I'm going to come here and measure 11.75, 6, 7. Yeah. Then come here and measure 11.75. Yeah. Now we're gonna connect. We're gonna connect with our curve, and because it's not straight. So this is what we're doing on page 69. Oh, 60. Yes, I think it's the 69. So this is what we're looking at. So we're gonna figure out how to place our curve. So I'll come to the U side. It's a bit straight. From the E line is a bit curvy to the balance mark at the down part of the E line, but I'm going to curve this like so. I'll need to get the down to be able to connect to, because there's no guideline at the E line. So I need to get these places straight. Then before the balance mark, it's a bit curvy. Then I'll come to this side and also figure out how to draw it. And like this, place it from U, you connect to your point E. Seems to be like this. So the balance mark. Curvy to this place. Then I'm going to go in to this side. The point E and take my curve like this. So I have that curvy. So this is what it's going to look like. Oh, this is what it looks like. This place out. If it is too loose, you can also make it more fitted around the wrist. If you feel like it's too loose, you can go ahead and tighten it. So to 2.5 cm. All right, so the amount that you feel comfortable. So we're gonna slash this out, take it out. On the down part, I'm going to throw it. Throw it, and also, if you don't want to hold it, that's can take it out from the down part. Also ensure that your body's blob is, it has been tested. When I say tested, you have drafted it and you have tried it on the calico, sized it to see if the ample is okay and every other thing is fine before you try out your sleeve on it. So it requires practice trying out. If you don't want to come down, take the amount of dirt that you have. shaped sleeve. The semi shaped sleeve. So we'll be looking at more sleeves in the next class.